So now we are okay with the software. We can start with the explore perspective. So again, you can go down your own paces, switching between the this presentation and your done configuration. So the next thing would be to change to the de-explore perspective. Okay, so if you change to the that de-explore perspective, you will see here that the same file that we had opened, a script that we tested, was opened there. So you can just close it, and then we will continue with the exercise here. So once you are in the explore perspective, you can set the current plot as the connected to the Python console. So for this, we have to click on the plot view, which is this, and when you click on this one, the bottoms here change. So if you see, you click different parts of the perspective, the toolbox it adapts automatically and changes. So when you click here on the dataset plot, then the next thing is set current plot as default on the dev console, and that will open a Python console. So you get a pop-up. You click OK. I think you shouldn't have a list if you only installed one Python. I have three versions of Python, so I just click on the 3.8, which is the latest.
Yeah.
And that changes this part of the screen, which is the console.
Mm.
If you can see this here on this side, you see three things are happening. The dataset plot is now connected to the console. The console loaded CSoftPy, which is a library that connects Python to DOM. And it set the name of the plotting space using this command. So now we have connected the plot and the console. But we have connected with the data that's on the plot at the moment. So every time we change this, we may need to refresh the plot. So run this command again. The console has a memory. So if you click the up and down arrows on your keyboard, you'll see the list of the previous commands that you executed. So you can easily look and run the same command again. Lines that start with a hashtag, they are just comments. So they are not executed. So the lines that have no hashtag are the ones that are commands. And so if you do this again, that connects the console to the plotting section. So these are the things that we see here if we follow. So we are now up to the slide number 6. And now we are going to be opening the first file, which is this powder image file taken from one of the devices in Diamond. So the name of the file is POW M99S5. So in the examples folder, now again in your de-explore perspective, on the left side, you have the POW. So the way you open it is you double click, or you drag and drop, or you click on open file, whichever is easier for you, and you see this image. So we are going to be working on modifying this image from the console. So doing some experiments. The last experiment requires us to use drawing of array region. I'll use, if you know how to use the DOM, you can select a region which selects some part of the data. So for that, you click on on the toolbox, each of the perspectives have a small toolbox. So in the toolbox for the dataset plot, to select a region, you just click on this one that has like a little spanner with a part of a rectangle, and then you have region editor. So if you click on region editor, now your cursor changes and you can draw a region there. And that's it. That's what we say when we mean draw a region. So we will use this in the later in the exercises. So now we are just going to be to start changing this code here. So the next thing is explains a bit the console view. So it's the thing that I already explained. So this is the text. It tells you that some of the lines are comments, what is happening. So you can either connect and get the data again by doing this selecting and set current plot as default. So that the thing that does, if you notice, is automatically sends this command to the console. So I click here, I click on set current plot as default, and it gives me two lines. The first one is connecting the plot to the dataset plot, and the second line is the actual command that does the connection. So that's the next stage. Are we okay up to this point? Everyone is okay?
Can you repeat the last part, Abraham? So I got lost after the selection of the rectangle. So and then afterwards, what we need to do?
Oh, you just click on dataset plot, and then okay. Try to click go to the toolbar. Mm-hmm. This one that has the OpenPyDev console.
Okay.
You click on this arrow and set current plot as default.
Okay.
That generates this. So you could do as well just with the up and down arrows and look for the command, which is this one. And that has the same effect. You are connecting, and now DNP, the console and the plot are connected. So the next thing is we are going to try to get the data from the plot. And the way we do this is getting a data bin. The next page, page 8, gives you 5 commands. So if we execute one after another, we will be pulling data from the plot, passing the data to a variable, and then we can use this variable to see different parts of the data. So the first command is dnp plot get data bin. So the data bin is the object that has the data for this plot. So if we use, you can type it or use select and copy and paste. So what I did is just selected this text and copy and then paste it there. So DB now is a variable that has the data bin, and if you see is a structure that contains all the data in this image as array or a matrix of values for all each of the value points, and we can use explore the data inside this data bin by doing this, creating a new variable called data. So what this next statement does is creates a variable named data and copies the data inside the data bin to this variable so we can explore it better. So if you again copy and paste, so that gives you the variable. And you see that data is an array. So arrays have different properties, or the variables have they automatically get the properties when you pass the data. So this variable has the three properties, which are shape, minimum, and maximum. And what is minimum, shape, minimum, and maximum? Okay, see, if you type data dot shape and enter, it gives you a pair of values, which is actually the length and width of this array. So the number of points in this image is 2,527 times 2,463. So those are all the points in the image. Each of these points has a different value, which goes from a minimum and a maximum. So the minimum value on this region is -2, and the largest value in this image is 9,132. You can start exploring the data and seeing different values. And for instance, if you wanted to see what value is on which point, you can use the indexes in the array used to tell you what's the value at this at some point. So that's when we start exploring variables and data, so and how we extract the data from data bins.